Hello everyone. Today we're going to explain how to use an oscilloscope in the process of repairing hash boards. Mastering its usage can greatly increase efficiency. This video mainly covers the setup of this oscilloscope, as well as the measurement methods during hash board repair. Today, I'm using the UTD2102CEX Plus oscilloscope. Let's start by explaining its button functions and setup methods. This is the power switch of the oscilloscope. Let's turn it on first. Press here for frequency settings. F2 is for language settings. Then rotate this knob to set the language. After selecting the language, press this knob to confirm the setting. And finally press menu to return. Blue and yellow here represent two test channels. To set channel 1, press the upper button. For channel 2, press the lower button. Today, we're using channel 1, so we can turn off channel 2 by pressing this button twice in succession. Next, let's set up this menu button. Press F3 to set it to AC mode. Use this knob for selection, and then press it. Press F4, select the normal mode with the knob, and press to confirm. Press this button, then F1, rotate the knob and press it, thus setting it to AC mode. We can see a 1x here, referring to the probe mode. The default of the oscilloscope is 1x, remember this mode. And press menu to return. Okay, continue to set its amplitude and frequency. This knob here can set the frequency, set it to 10 microseconds. The adjacent knob can set the amplitude, here it needs to be set to 1 volts. For testing different models of hash boards, these amplitude and frequency settings can be adjusted. The values I've set here are applicable to most hash board tests. During testing, if the waveform doesn't display, it might be due to incorrect parameters here. Change them and the waveform will display. This is the oscilloscope probe. Because the original clips cable is too short and not very convenient, we can make an extension like this probe cable, which makes it easier to measure chip signals anywhere on the hash board. Insert the probe into channel 1 of the oscilloscope, and tighten it clockwise. The other end of the probe can be hooked here. Alright, the oscilloscope is now set up. Now, let's demonstrate the specific use of this tool in the process of repairing hash boards. To test the signal waveforms of the ASIC chips on the hash board, we need to use a test fixture to control the output signal waveforms of the hash board. A PW3 plus power supply, for powering the tester. Dual row cooler fans for cooling the hash board. Adjustable voltage PSU for powering the hash board. We're first measuring the Antminer S19j Pro hash board, so the voltage here needs to be set to 15 volts. Continue connecting the relevant cables. The oscilloscope's probe clip needs to be clamped to the negative pole of the hash board. Then turn on the power, and press the test button on the test fixture. When measuring, the probe's setting here needs to be X1, consistent with the oscilloscope settings. The other side is X10. Toggle the orange button to select. Okay, we can start measuring the signal waveforms now. From the oscilloscope screen, we can see that each signal's waveform is different. Next, let's continue connecting a Whatsminer hash board for measurement. Similarly, first connect the relevant cables. This hash board is an M32. Change the voltage here to 13 volts. Then turn on the power, select the hash board model, and press the test button. We measure the CLK signal, TXD signal, and RXD signal in turn. Alright, that's how to use the oscilloscope. It can quickly determine whether the ASIC chip's signal is normal during the repair process. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a message for discussion. Thank you, everyone.